Assalamu alaikum, and I welcome you all for the next video on PLC programming. And in this video we are going to discuss about some of the very basic concepts of PLC programming and how we can do AND, OR, XOR, NOT gate using a simple normally open and normally closed switches. Now regarding PLC, so PLC uses graphical icons, which means unlike our English like languages which is used in the case of CPP or Arduino or any other thing. So it is very simple. There are some graphical icons, so which we need to pick it from the library, and using the library we can do some programs in case of PLC. Now this PLC is also called as ladder logic diagram or ladder logic programming. Why it is so? So because it uses two vertical lines which is called as a power rails, okay. So it will be like this. So we have two vertical rails. Across the rail, so we'll be doing the all our logical things. Like, so let me draw one normally open switch, and let me draw one normally closed switch, and I can have one output. Like in that way, we can do something. So across the power rails, these power rails are basically equivalent to the power source, like the plus and minus of a battery. So across the battery we will be connecting the electrical terminals. Similar to that one, so we have some two vertical rails. So across the rails we will be doing all our programs. So in that way it is called as ladder logic diagram. Now in case of PLC, input always precedes the output. Therefore, so it should start with an input, or it should start with the a series of input before an output. Okay. Now in case of PLC, so the IOs are numbered depending on the manufacturer. So in case of Mitsubishi, so the input is numbered as X and output is numbered as Y. Whereas in case of Fanuc, so input is numbered as I and output is numbered as Q. So it is logically it is same, but based on the manufacturer, so we will be giving different nomenclature for input and output. Now regarding the ladder symbols which is used in the PLC, so in this video we are going to use very simple ladder symbols, namely NO and NC switches. So this is basically called as NO. And this is NC switch. Okay, so this is NO. What is NO? So NO stands for let me give some other colors. Let me give red color here. Just wait. So this is called as normally open switch. It is a normally open switch. And what is NC? And NC stands for normally closed switch. Let me give some other color. Let me select blue color, and I'll show you that one also. Normally closed. What is the difference between normally open and normally closed? So let me have another look, and I'll show another simple diagram. So this is how your NO and NC looks like. So it is the illustration is here is basically about NO based push button and NC based push button. NO and NC based push button. Okay, now in the first picture on my right, the first picture, so if you look at this picture, when you apply a force over here, so what will happen? So this will close, which means it closes and ensures the movement of current from this end to that end. So before that, it is open. It is open. So once it is pressed, so it closes like this. So this is the NO. So which means basically NO will not conduct once force is applied by the way of switching action. So it the contact is closed here and it causes switching action. Now regarding NC switch, so you can see in this diagram, so when you apply your force, what will happen? It breaks the contact. I'll show here. Okay. So this is basically what. Now, by default, it is closed, which means it ensures the current from this end to that end. Once it is pressed, what will happen? It opens the contact. It opens the contact like this. So it opens, and by the way, there is no passage of current from this end to that end. Okay. So basically, NO does not allow the current, but when you apply the force, it allows the current. Whereas in case of NC, by default, it will allow the current. By means of switching action, it breaks the flow of current. Okay. So let me have a video, a simple video about this, and I'll show you a simple video where you can see the normally open and normally closed switch. So just watch this, and you can see here. Okay. So you have a contact here. You have a switching contact here. I'm connecting two terminals to the battery or to the power supply. It is connected, and I'm giving another end which is connected to the battery supply. Now you can see here. You can see in this place, and here is normally open type, and here is normally closed one. So the example shown in this video has normally open as well as normally switch, closed switch, just by single push. So you can have a two switch, normally open as well as normally closed. Okay, I'll show the video again. You can see. So there is tick tick sound, which means the contact is make or break on one end, similarly make on break on. So in case of NO, contact will be make contact. In case of NC, so you have a break in contact. So this is how the NO and NC switch works like. Now with that, we'll go to logical operation, how we can do logical AND OR gate. Now this is the truth table for logical AND. Which says that if both the input is pressed, then only you will have an output. For the other combinations, you have two inputs here. For other combinations, so there will be no output. So only for only when the both the switches are pressed. How it is now? You can see. So if A is pressed, that is switch one is pressed, and B is pressed, that is switch two is pressed. So which means one and one here. So this is the fourth line of this. This is the fourth line. So which means your output, your solenoid, the output can be anything. So this output just I mentioned here, it may be a motor. You can operate a motor or a light, or you can operate a buzzer, etc. So anything can be operated here, okay, in the output. So as per the logic, so when both the inputs are pressed, so then only you will have an output. Okay. So for other combination, other combination, it will not block. Which means if this is pressed, if this is not pressed, so current will move from to this place up to this, which means there is no power at the output. And another option, if this is pressed, if this is not pressed, there is no flow of power from the power supply, which means this is open, and so there is no output. So this is how the logical AND is operating, and we demonstrated this with the help of two normally open switches. Okay, so let us go to the next slide, that is logical OR. So this is the truth table for logical OR, and it works like this. Now when there is no input in the switch 1 and the switch 2, we will have no output. For the other combination, if any one of the switches is pressed or both the switches are pressed, if any one of the switch or both the switches are pressed, then you will have an output. Okay, how it works? So you have two normally open switch. So you can see here you have two normally open switch. So these are connected like this. So this is what is called as OR operation. So parallel connection OR operation. So when you press this switch, what will happen? Current will flow from this direction to the output. When you press this switch, instead of pressing A, if you press B, what will happen? Again, current will flow from the battery and it causes the output to run. So this is how logical OR operation works like. So you can see in the slide again. So this is the truth table. So for the output to run, we need to press any one of the switches. So this is the PLC program for the logical OR operation. So next we have logical NOT. What is logical NOT? So logical NOT is inversion. Okay. So we'll be inverting this. So basically it is equivalent to inverting. Let me have a red color and I'll show the text. It is inverting. Which means if you have 0, NOT will invert that as 1. If you have 1, NOT will invert that as 0. Which means if nothing is pressed, you will have an output. If you press the switch, you have no output. For the logical NOT, so basically we'll be using normally closed switch. So this is the symbol for the normally closed switch, which we discussed in the previous slide. Now you can see by default, so when nothing is pressed, so you have the flow of current from this end to that end, causing the output to run. If you press this, what will happen? So this will break. If you press this, the switch will open like this. So now the switch will look like this. It will open, allowing no flow of current. So for logical NOT operation, so we'll be using normally closed switch, right? Next we'll go to logical NAND. How we can perform logical NAND? What does this NAND stands for? NAND is NOT plus AND. Now you can see in the truth table. This is the truth table for AND operation, which we discussed in the previous slides. This is the truth table for the AND operation. Now you can see here, in case of NAND, So everything is inverted. So 0 to 1, that is for these three combination output. Output, I am talking about output. So I have 1 here. So when there is an 1, it will be inverted as 0. It is inverted as 0. So this is the truth table for logical NAND. It is not of AND. It is not of AND. How to do the PLC program? So here is the PLC program for the logical NAND. Logical NAND. So you have two. You have two normally closed switch. That is input 1 and input 2. So it is connected in parallel. When you press either 1 or 2, if you press either 1 or 2, what will happen? Output will run. When nothing is pressed, since it is a normally closed switch, so by default, output will run. So that is given in the first three rows of the truth table. So when nothing is pressed or any one of the switches pressed, you will have an output. So I'll explain how it is. When nothing is pressed, so since both are normally closed, there is a flow of current from this end to this end, so output will run. When input 2 is pressed, so this will open and there is no flow of current here, whereas since it is closed when nothing is pressed, so current flows from this end to this that end, causing output to run. When instead of pressing input 2, if you press input 1, what will happen? So the flow of power from this end is stopped, whereas power flows from this end to this end, causing output to run. This is the logical NAND operation. And what will happen if both are pressed? If both are pressed, power from this direction is blocked. Power from this direction also blocked. Therefore, you have no output at the other end. Okay. So this is how we need to do logical NAND operation. So A is the equivalent diagram, and B is the ladder logic diagram. Next, we'll go to logical NOR operation. So you can see the truth table here. So you can see the truth table of logical NOR. So logical NOR is, what is logical NOR? Yes, you are correct. So like NAND, so here it is called as NOT plus R. So you can see the truth table. You can see the truth table here. This is the truth table for R operation. So first row 00, you have 0, 01 also it is 1, 10 is 1, 11 is 1. This is the logical OR operation. Since it is a not of R, you can see 0 is inverted. Let me change the color. Okay, so you can see 0 is inverted as 1. For the 3 remaining combination, 1 is inverted as not, that is nothing, 0. How it is performed? So let us have explanation at this side. Okay, that is picture B. When nothing is pressed, input 1 is normally closed, input 2 also normally closed. This causes the output to run. That is the first line of the truth table. If you press 1, which means power supply will be blocked. So there will be no flow of power supply from the battery. Or if you press 2, power supply this end also blocked. Or if you press both 1 and 2, there will be no flow of power supply and output will not run. So this is what the remaining three lines of the truth table. So for NOR operation, when nothing is pressed, let me do it again. In case of logical NOR, so this is the truth table. So when nothing is pressed, when nothing is pressed. That is line number one. You have an output. For the remaining three combination, so you have no output. You have no output. So this is how the logical NOR used in, and this is what is called as PLC program for logical NOR operation. Logical NOR operation. Okay. Let us go to next one. XOR, exclusive OR. So this XOR stands for exclusive OR. How it works. And before that, let me write what is this XOR is. So XOR stands for exclusive OR. Exclusive OR. So in case of exclusive OR, since the name is called as exclusive OR, so we need to have this thing. Any one of the input should be pressed. If both the inputs are pressed, that is, I'll show again, that is this one. So let me highlight this one. Since it is an exclusive OR, you can see this one. So any one of, it is a must that we need to press any one of the switch. If both the switches are pressed, you will have no output. Similarly, if both the switches are not pressed, then only you will not have an output. Okay, so therefore, in case of XOR, any one of, it is mandatory that any one of the switch alone should be pressed. Not both the switch, any one of the switch should be pressed. Okay, how it works? Now you can see this, you have input 1 and input 2. In the first line, input 1 is normally open, whereas the second line, so I have the same input, but it is normally closed. It is connected as normally closed. Now in case of input 2, you can see in the first line it is normally closed, whereas in the second line it is normally open. Now let us go step by step, line by line. Now in the first line, 0, 0, nothing is pressed. When nothing is pressed, input 1 in the first line is open, there is no power supply. Now in the second line, input 2 is open, there is no power supply, which means output will not run. So when input 1 is not pressed as well as input 2 is not pressed, what will happen? So there is a break of power supply at this line as well as at this line. Okay. So this is the truth table for the first line. This is the verification for the first line. If you take the second one, so this one. Second one, which means input 2 is pressed. So if input 2 is pressed in the first line, this will open. So causing no flow of electric supply, power supply. Already input 1 is open, already there is no power supply. In addition to this, you are making input 2 as open. Whereas in the second line, since input 2 is pressed, what will happen? So this will be closed. So causing power supply to move from the battery to this side, causing the output to run. This is the truth table explanation for the second line. So if input 2 is pressed in the first line here, it is open, whereas in the second line it will be closed. Already input 1 is not pressed, it is closed, so power supply moves from this end to this end. If you go to the second line, sorry, if you go to the third line, if you go to the third line, so let me mark this. If you go to the third line, in third line, input 1 is pressed, which means this will close. So causing power supply to move to this end, already 2 is closed because it is not pressed here. You can see it is not pressed here, therefore power supply moves from to this end, causing the output to run. That is the third line. Whereas in case of second line, you can see this will open. So already 2 is also open. So when this is pressed, 1 is pressed and 2 is not pressed, through the first line power supply goes and causing the output to run. So let us check the last line. So in the last line, so again let me mark this. If both are pressed, switch 1 and 2 are pressed, you will have no output. Last line, you will have no output. Now when you press 1, what will happen? In the first line, this may be closed, but this will open. See it again. When one is pressed, so this will be closed, whereas this will be open, whereas in the first line, switch 1 will be closed. So causing power to move up to this place. Whereas in case of the second switch, let me select a red color so that I can differentiate. If you press switch 2, what will happen? In the second line, you have closed the input 2 here, whereas you caused this to open. Therefore, in the first line, power moves from here to here, there is a break of power supply. And in the second line, already there is a break of power supply. Even if you close it, so nothing will happen and output 2 will closed. Output will not run and output is closed. So there is no power supply at the output. So this is how we can do logical and or not NAND, NOR and XOR using a normally open switch and normally closed switch. So I thank you everyone for watching the video. So let us see in the next video with some other content. Thank you.